that he told me those are open problem, why you not solve it? I don't have time to do it. I have a lot of works. Currently, I'm almost most interested in, you know, this stuff. So, play the game. I ask a student to do that. They should do that. They are, you know, some of my students is in very low level student. They should do that for their own career, not for you. But in the future book, should be some material and play the game here, and some material and play the game here, as I definitely, but I don't know. I don't have time to finish this work. Okay? Really, that probably should be much more important than how to solve this problem. But here, I still give some comment. I have introduced so this is Peterson graph. Is it one for tolerant Hamiltonian? Is it one for tolerant Hamiltonian? It is. PM1 is one for tolerant Hamiltonian. If n greater than 3 and n is even, Peterson graph is PN2 is one for tolerant Hamiltonian. Is if one, n equal to 1, 2, 3, Mach 6. And PN3 is 1 for tolerant Hamiltonian if n is odd with n greater than 7. And PN4 is 1 for tolerant Hamiltonian if n is odd and n is not 12. So you can still work on it if you want. And here is a honeycomb. I don't know the problem. What this is called honeycomb kinetic, cube kinetic. I have introduced a cube kinetic cycle. So this is cube kinetic cycle. So cube kinetic cycle, I think most of you may be interested. This is a Kelly graph. Is it one for tolerant Hamiltonian? I have proved it. It's not. It's still the proof is not easy. For n is up, okay. N is even, definitely not. Lovasz has conjectured that almost the vertex transitive is Hamiltonian. Almost every non-bipartite the vertex transitive graph is one for tolerant Hamiltonian. Maybe you can try. You can make it stronger. Later. Well, it's free. Conjecture is free. Okay, I have non-bipartite version. I have bipartite version. Yeah. So, okay. I'm sorry. I make a honeycomb mesh, I make a surrounder. So I call it a honeycomb disk. Every honeycomb disk is 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Okay, forget about the slide, the word in four. So up in upper side. So I still remember. I still have some things to say. There is an interesting problem proposed by Bill Gates. Here's a pancake. The pancakes, they serve the pancake, but the pancake is smaller and the order is random. So you must be reorganized from the smaller to the larger, right? But you have a, maybe you cannot use your finger, it's too dangerous, right? So you must what, pork or something like that. Flip it, flip it, flip it. Okay? Okay? This is a pancake. And this is a, so you the, so what is the Bill Gates done? The Bill Gates, the problem is, what is the minimum number of move to achieve your goal? The problem is still open. But what is the problem related to graph theory? This is maybe a permutation. You flip it, you create another permutation. You flip it, you create another permutation, right? So I create a graph, the vertices is maybe four pancake. Then maybe there is 1, 2, 3, four. And maybe this one is 2, 1, 3, 4. And the question is just the diameter. I just the diameter of this graph for PN. Why I introduce this graph? This graph is definitely 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Definitely. No problem. It's on my book. No problem. And
do you have any precise mathematical definition for what you call honeycomb disk?
Honeycomb disk, or maybe I have introduced a honeycomb mesh. Yes, last night I just made the formal definition. Maybe we can check with the book, the paper. Okay. Otherwise, yeah, they have a definition, formal definition. You can consider the pancake graph, the larger size, say about the P100, how about P100, right? So the PN is n vertices, is an n minus one regular, has n factorial number of vertices. Okay, I say, I can prove it. I have a paper to prove it. It is, it's n minus 3 for tolerant Hamiltonian, and n minus 4, I think this is 4, n minus 4 for tolerant Hamiltonian kinetic. How to prove it? I just say, I must prove it. Combine these two concepts and recursively prove it. Recursively construct it. So for a while, I was confused. What is a four-tolerant Hamiltonian? The relation between four-tolerant Hamiltonian and the Hamiltonian kinetic. The relationship with what seems you have seen a category one. What is a lot of graphs? They are a one vertex four tolerant Hamiltonian and Hamiltonian kinetic. So I think maybe four tolerant Hamiltonian definitely Hamiltonian kinetic, right? So for this reason. I have the following work. Here is the set of cubic Hamiltonian graph, and this is 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. This is 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. This should be 1-4 tolerant Hamiltonian, right? And this is Hamiltonian kinetic graph. If you want to say there's nothing, there's no relations between this family, I don't know how to say there's no relation, but we do have some relation, definitely. Everything has some relation, but we in mathematics, we say we don't have any relation. The only way to present it is every family, there exists at least one graph in each family. Is that right? Right. So we have already seen this family. We have a lot. We do have a lot because the category one. So this one. This one is one is for tolerant Hamiltonian. How to prove it? I already proved it yesterday. I say Hamilton create a puddle. He required every 4 8. Every 4 8, 1 2 3 4. You can extend it into a Hamiltonian cycle. Suppose I here, this one, then this 8 cannot be used. It cannot be in the Hamiltonian cycle, right? If I go this way, then this one cannot be used, included in the Hamiltonian cycle. So it is 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. It is not 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. It is It is not one vertex for tolerant Hamiltonian. I just delete this vertex. I have shown you with the preferred condition. Right? Did I? I think I did prove it. Yeah. I say this is not Hamiltonian. So this is one vertex board, not one vertex board. This is not Hamiltonian connected. I have shown you yesterday. There's no Hamiltonian pass between Sydney and the room. Right? So suppose I want to prove this graph is in region 3. I mean it is not 1-8-4 tolerant. I have shown you this graph is not Hamiltonian. So this one is not a Hamiltonian connected. I have shown you this is one, it is one vertex fault. I have told you that you can play the puzzle located these vertices. So it is not one vertex fault to Hamiltonian. It is one vertex fault to Hamiltonian. And Hamiltonian connected, well, fortunately, the number of vertices is not too big, so you can play the puzzle again and again by brute force. Okay? So, I'm going to show you this one. Is cubic is 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. It's 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. This graph is 1-8-4. Remember, this one is 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. It's 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. So I just add a tail, you will get. Right? This one is 1-8-4 tolerant, then the larger one is 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. So this one is 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Suppose I want to show you that it's not one vertex fault. I delete this vertex. I try to find a Hamiltonian cycle. But this is a three cycle. I must be consecutively traveled consecutively. Otherwise, otherwise, I will get into trouble. So every click of size 3 must be can be shrunk to a vertex. So that means delete this vertex is a Hamiltonian, but this is bipartite graph. You cannot shrink. The delete of this vertex is not Hamiltonian. This graph is Hamiltonian connected. Well, brute force, no problem. I don't know any other method to solve it. So, how to prove this graph is 1-8-4 tolerant Hamiltonian, one vertex 4 tolerant Hamiltonian? not Hamiltonian kinetic. Okay, let's shrink all the three cycles. Shrink all the three cycles. I will get this one. This one is smaller enough. I just proved by brute force. I checked this one is 1/8 for tolerant, one vertex for tolerant Hamiltonian. Then I can show. So that's the reason why I must introduce the three joint and the node expansion. The node expansion is just the either tail. Okay. So how to prove non-Hamiltonian kinetic? I just say there is no Hamiltonian path from these two vertices. So I take the plan back home, and I say, well, then I have two cases to discuss. Suppose I this one xz. Suppose I include this edge, so these two edges should be deleted. So after I delete it, then I play the Greenberg condition. I told you yesterday. Then it is not plane, not Hamiltonian. And it is suppose it is used, then again I play the Greenberg condition again. So suppose I want to prove this is a cubic Hamiltonian, one vertex four tolerant Hamiltonian, not 1/8 four tolerant Hamiltonian connected. How to get this graph? I already show you something. Yeah, this is just the adjoint of these two graphs. Just adjoint of these two graphs. Can you pick it up? I have this one inside out, something like that. You join this vertex with x join y, and flip it, you will get this. So how to prove it is Hamiltonian? It is Hamiltonian. This is 1/8 four tolerant Hamiltonian, and this one is Hamiltonian. And you first the right hand you give a Hamiltonian, then the idea is you have a three joint, you have a Hamiltonian cycle, then this one is actually 1/8 Hamiltonian, so you can do that. You don't know which one is used here, but this one is Hamiltonian. So extend it, then you find a Hamiltonian. Using the almost the same idea of three joint, but
it's one vertex four tolerant Hamiltonian. Okay. One vertex, why is one vertex four tolerant Hamiltonian? This one, this graph, the right graph is one four tolerant Hamiltonian. You can extend. You try to extend it here. And for this one Hamiltonian cycle, for this Hamiltonian cycle, but the vertex y is carefully selected. They guarantee you can use any two. This just because this vertex is very this vertex is very very carefully selected. This vertex is very careful selected. Then it is the Hamiltonian cycle. This one is missing, it's okay. This one is missing, it's okay. This one is missing, it's okay. So you that's last.
However, the graph is not 1/8 four tolerant Hamiltonian. How to prove it? Well, the proof is easy. I have told you that
The larger one is 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian. Even only the smaller one is 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian. Since the smaller one is not 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian, so it is not 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian. I have told you the delete of AB is not Hamiltonian. So the proof is easy. Yeah. Okay. It is not a Hamiltonian connected. So it is not Hamiltonian connected. This proof is again easy. Suppose you have a Hamiltonian pass from C to D. What? From C to D. Suppose you have a Hamiltonian pass from this one to this one, to this one. Actually, this one is actually a vertex. So you have, in your part, you have a Hamiltonian pass from C to D. Because this is just a vertex joined with another vertex here. So the again the proof, so the graph is not Hamiltonian connected. So now it's in region 7. Okay. This is a three joint of these two graphs. This is the A joint of these two graphs. Okay. So H is Hamiltonian. This one is carefully, the edge is very carefully selected. So you can extend the Hamiltonian cycle inside, extend the Hamiltonian cycle. So 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian. Suppose the larger one is 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian. The smaller one should be 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian. However, the smaller one is not 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian, so larger one. It's ridiculous. It's that easy. I should not present here. But I think that's the interesting part. So, one word has fought. Yeah. What is the word I see? Okay, here. Suppose that this one is 40, you have a Hamiltonian cycle, then that means delete this one, you have a Hamiltonian cycle. Delete this one. And I have already showed that this one is deleted and this one can be shrinked into a cycle. So you cannot have a Hamiltonian cycle with this one. Hamiltonian connected, well, then brute force. I don't have any other choice to show you that. And this one is in region 8, so this is an A joint of this one and that one. So this one is a this one is carefully this next Hamiltonian cycle is you can extend it here, yeah. So K is this one is not 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian, yeah. I played again. Suppose. Suppose the larger one is 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian, then the smaller one is 1/8 tolerant Hamiltonian. However, the smaller one is not. So it's not. Again, for Hamiltonian connected part, There is no Hamiltonian path between this, these two vertices. So there is no relationship between 184 tolerant and vertex 4 tolerant and Hamiltonian kinetic. So what we meant actually tell you that here is something missing. But I show you another family of graph. Here is a I call this is I1, I call this is I2, and I call it I3, and I call this one I4, and I5, I6, I8. You know what constructed. Can you? Okay. The I is bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Okay?
It is proved, but it is not on paper. I don't have time to write down. The I graph. It is written. No problem. It is written. The I graph is 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. It's 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian except n equal to 2.
I like this family because. This is something like a polar coordinate of radius and angle. So maybe I just think about maybe geometric. You want to build a network for in Russia, right? Maybe this is a candidate. I don't know, but up to. I also believe that there are many things to be considered, not mathematical. This one may be something you have a hierarchical structure, but you also have a local structure. It's compared with the broader tree, the Christmas tree. Only report to your leader, to your boss. It's not that good, you know, communist, too communist. But you still have a local factor. Yeah. Okay. This is this is not written. You already know this is polar coordinate. So this is south pole and north pole and join together so you get an Earth, right? It's an Earth graph. I don't know. Can you imagine? Okay, it's Earth, right? And it is 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. It is 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. And I have been introduced in broader tree. So then I should report to you. So the classification of the Harari's problem, he wants us to classify all 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Well, there are a lot of problems, open problem in the book, in the journal. You cannot follow. And I think the problem is so I try to limit myself on the construction part, and I have to show you a very interesting part called three joint. Is there any others? Actually, I have shown you another. I did show you another, but I call it a cycle extension. What is cycle extension? This. You pick a cycle. You pick a cycle, and the same structure I have. So this is cycle extension. You pick any 1/4 tolerant Hamiltonian graph, you can replace this graph, and pick any cycle, maybe this cycle, or maybe you like this cycle. It's okay. You extend it in this fashion. How to extension? How do you mean? you take a cycle and insert by 2 AD, 2 AD, 2 AD, 2 AD, 2 AD, 2 AD, and not 2 AD, that's an even number of AD. Yeah, but the zero is not even. Okay. Okay. It is published. I have other construction. Maybe I can discuss with you later. Later, not today. Okay. Today almost done. Okay. It's interesting. This graph is called Peterson graph. Peterson graph. Peterson graph is not. Is not Hamiltonian. It's not. It is a hyper Hamiltonian. What does it mean hyper Hamiltonian? The delete any vertex is Hamiltonian, but the original graph is not Hamiltonian. However, I try to make a cycle extension. What do you get? Take a guess. It is one Hamiltonian. One for tolerant Hamiltonian, yeah. And you can repeat it. I think it's, once you repeat it, it's okay already, yeah. So, remember I told you that Lovasz had conjectured that every vertex transitive graph is one for tolerant Hamiltonian. It's Hamiltonian. But it seems that you see, the Peterson graph is one vertex for tolerant Hamiltonian. In the sense that the original graph is not Hamiltonian, but the remaining graph is Hamiltonian. Right? Still has some interesting relation. I don't know, but there are a lot of I don't know. Okay, I think I should. Okay, the final remark I should. I think there's something I should tell you. That. Yeah. The Brother tree is diameter 2 log n. Can you lower the diameter? Definitely, yes. Definitely, yes. How to do that? I don't know how to do that. I just I know it is because I know it is because where is Brother Chu? Where is Christmas Chu? The idea of the Christmas tree, I link it in the cycle. So I just I change the order, something like that. I jump some here. Experiment result, it indicates the diameter can be low. Can be low. So I think you still have something to do, but what is the answer? I don't know. Okay. But I can do that in with the experimental result. In the slide that I have introduced you, I didn't talk. Did not talk, but in the second chapter, I have introduced a graph called DTN. DTK, dense trivalent graph. If you read it, it is a trivalent graph, but its diameter is approximately 1.5 log n. the computer scientists just want to build a graph, a cubic graph, diameter as low as possible, that's 1.5. Up to my knowledge, it's 1.5. So if you want to ask for more condition on for tolerant Hamiltonian, or even Hamiltonian, I don't know if this graph is Hamiltonian in the remark of chapter 2. I think it is Hamiltonian. But definitely, this graph is not 1.4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Okay? So, maybe any questions? Or I take a break? I still have 10 minutes, but yeah. Okay, then, any question? Yeah. Yeah.
I graph which I've shown and
isomorphic what?
Cycle extension graphs.
The cycle extension. Yeah. You take the I graph, you always take I graphs cycle extension. I1, I2, I3, I4. Yeah.
They are isomorphic?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. That's why I get the I graph. I just to perform I expansion. Perform cycle extension, always on the outer side.
What about Hamiltonicity of graphs of valency three? There are many interesting results in valency three, and what about valency greater than three?
Can you告诉我? Huh? Yeah, yes, yeah, that's easy. That I can answer. I have told you about the pancake graph, right? So you should the problem is consider irregular graph. I don't want not regular, right? Irregular graph. So I have a lot of irregular graph. Such graph, the delete of n minus 2 vertices remain Hamiltonian. This is the optimal you can do. Can you, right? Because if you delete all the edges of a vertex, right? And so this n minus 3 for Hamiltonian transitive, you can find a lot of paper on that. That's the reason, I answer. Why you not do this? Why you not do this? I don't have time, really. Yeah. I hope you can do that. Yeah. They have a lot of paper on that. And most of these papers are done by recursive construction and by the recursive on using recursive induction. Yeah. Any other question? So again, as I told you yesterday. So what is the next you are going to do? You already asked me a question. What can you do next? I have already done. So what next I can do? the reason I'm here, I already show you what next I can do, right? From the very beginning, the part of Harari gave me, he's a friend, he's my friend, right? How to solve it, really? It's really a part of, right? Maybe I should give you a part of, maybe discuss next day. Maybe go, yes. It's easy, you know. I really want to show you this one. It's quite related. Also, here is a path.
pass. I know. There is a one more H two. There is a pass of pass.
Oh, how to stop it? Please stop it. How to stop it?
Okay, here is a pass. Pass of 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it should be, I call it a pass 4. not pass 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Regular class, I think pass. So suppose 1/8 is 4. 1/8 is 4. You should, how many 8 do you want to, 8, 1, 8, 8, 8, some 8 to keep it to be remain as a pass of length 4. So this here already give you the answer. I should. Some people will tell me that four tires. No, I say there are five tires in your car. No, in the garage you will find one. In the back, right? In the back, there's an extra, right? So this solution, I will ask you how many tires in your car? You may be eight. One tire, one repair. One just maybe redundant for the pair, right? So which, okay, so you know, again, so the problem is, you want to give your network, okay, or graph, you want eight some ages, as I discussed the whole cycle. So how about this one? How about this one? Try to add as minimal number of ages as possible, and still 1/8 curve, you still have this graph. Okay, definitely you have a choice. Every age is repeated. That's true. Maybe too ridiculous. You make a torus. Definitely work from the magic point of view. Definitely work, right? It's very smart. Can you improve it? Or prove it is not optimal. Or prove it is possible. It is optimal. I challenge to you as a, I will tell you, day after tomorrow, you still have some time, but you know what I'm talking about, the problem, right? The problem is so easy, too easy, right? Okay. Yeah, okay. Okay, so any other questions?